When I was a kid, nothing screamed the future like holograms, or at least the pop culture representation of them. Me and many others were very eager for a world where advertisements floated like a cyberpunk dystopia and the meatloaf was holographic. Well, a bit of clarification should be placed on that term hologram. An actual hologram, by definition, is just a three-dimensional image. Like a 3D photograph. Not like 3D TVs though, whereas standard 3D in mass consumer spaces is a 2D image given depth. Holograms can have full parallax movement. You can look around the object to see things you couldn't from, you know, before. These exist, actually, but they're not quite the holograms that we were promised in science fiction decades ago. Images that don't have depth inside the display, but rather actually pop out of the screen, floating in the air as if they were real. These are complicated. They're not actually holograms, they're volumetric displays. It should be noted that many pop culture references, even now, to holograms, like the Tupac and the... And this. These actually use Pepper's Ghost, which has been in use for hundreds of years. You take a mirror at 45 degree angles and it creates an illusion of a 3D image. It's not a hologram and it's not floating in air, but it gets the job done for these purposes. But how hard would it be to actually have a true untethered volumetric display as seen in media like this and this and this and this? We have volumetric displays right now, but they're encased in glass. They are 3D, yes, but they're not popping out of the screen. That glass is very essential to making all of this work. See, light is photons. That's a particle, but it can also function as a wave. Now, waves have the defining property of being, wavy. They have crests and troughs, ups and downs, and can vary in amplitude and frequency. Unlike standard particles, they can exist and overlap within a superposition, two waves in the same physical space. When they overlap, this causes interference, and the basic sum of the up points and the down points can either make bigger waves or smaller waves, or it can cancel it out entirely. This should make sense for anybody that's splashed around in a pool. Now, when these troughs and these crests overlap properly and they cancel out, this is called phase cancellation. This is actually how noise canceling headphones work, by recreating the noise of the outside world as sort of a phase shifted inverse. This is also why the audio in my videos sometimes sounds weird, because I phase shift all of it. I don't know why. I think I messed up with the preset I made, and maybe I'll fix that. When light waves overlap in this manner, well, you can see the same basic principles apply. Phase cancellation results in darker or invisible spaces of light. If you can control the phases of light and how it shifted, you could create an image. The problem is, light doesn't generally have uniform properties. Standard flashlights or a light bulb or the sun send waves in all directions with varying frequencies and amplitudes. But luckily for us, we do have manageable forms of light. It's a laser. Lasers can have consistent frequency and amplitude and can make phase shifting much easier. Some of you might be asking then, why not just shoot a laser and control its phasing to create a proper image floating in the air? Well, you can't really stop light in midair, not easily at least. The only way we've been able to do this is with a mixture of gases cooled to near absolute zero. There's a few other problems though. Lasers aren't that safe. In Back to the Future 2, Marty McFly would be in actual danger when Jaws pops out at him, because once it overlaps with his eyes, it could just burn his retinas out. All of these physical hurdles make holograms the holograms of film may be impossible. I mean, R2-D2's projector would require cooling the room to temperatures where the very bodies of Obi-Wan and Luke would enter a super state of matter. They would be poisoned by the gases to control that temperature, and then it would just be filled with dust or fog as a medium to be able to see the image, all the while the lasers burning their eyes out. So if these can't work, if these kind of displays aren't really maybe possible, what now? Other systems include using audio waves and manipulating light pieces of matter like styrofoam to create moving images.
Best concept I've come across doesn't actually use phase shifting of the light, not in the way other holograms have, at least. Instead, it's actually more in line with this technology, the acoustic styrofoam technology. But instead of being moved acoustically, it's moved using photophoresis. The specifics of this phenomenon are not entirely relevant to the video, but understand that it allows us to control the movement of the particles with lasers.
Existing non-volumetric displays, but actual holograms, use the laser phase shifting properties to create these really cool photographs. And there is a question of whether this could be used in, say, a moving image, a 3D full parallax display. A great paper was written in 2019 about this very concept. I'll leave a link in the description. But it describes a display that you could truly look inside from any angle. If 3D TV was ever to make a comeback, it would likely be in this form. There's another element of holograms that have always interested me, which is use case. Almost every practical element of this holographic technology can be done today through AR systems. Augmented reality glasses, they're a thing that exist. Granted, right now they are pretty expensive and limited by low field of view and bulky setups, but they're real. Compared to the logistical problems of cooling a room to near absolute zero, in the gases, in the lasers, this is a fine compromise. After all, you would need a computer anyway to use a lot of this stuff. Why not just attach it to yourself and forego the cameras in the specialized room? This kind of technology is advancing fast, with even Apple considering jumping into it in a few years. And personally, I think this kind of stuff is what holograms would actually become, just a digital representation in a physical space.
It's possible that this stuff from BYU won't actually scale to consumer levels, and then the logistics with dealing with open heat and moving particles and mirrors, well, all that's still up in the air. In the meantime, I think it's fair to say that this technology is it's a long time away from consumer level tech. At least, contrary to my assumption that going into the making of this video, that no holograms or volumetric displays would technically be possible, this is at least, you know, it's possible.
Until that point, though, let's just sit back and enjoy what we have, because this is not happening. This, it is happening. So, yeah, won't be too long before you're sitting back and eating the holographic meatloaf.